First off, when you go to Google, you will see the self-help page, and this you can find it from canada.ca, and it's one of the government websites of Canada. It has some advice how to manage your debt if you have any, and the first step would be to list all your debts from highest interest to lowest interest. And then there's an icon here where you can go to check your debt and saving goals. And there's a budget planner as well. It's all free. You can, you know, enter your budget, save and review, and download templates, which I find pretty helpful for some people. And then it will tell you about all the details in terms of interest rates. Okay, the next one I would like to share with you is the high interest savings that you potentially want to look into. As you can see, RBC right now is offering 4.5% for high yield savings account. It's not locked in, it's just for the first 3 months. And then you see Tangerine has a 5% on high yield savings account, and others are lower, so you can just browse through and check. I find it pretty helpful sometimes to browse through and find some information. The next one I want to talk to you about is regarding self-directed mortgage RRSP that I found information about, which not a lot of people know about. So I can imagine with the high interest rate environment, a lot of people probably might be worried about their mortgages matured, and right now they have to look into either variable rates or fixed rates and possibly locking them in. And instead of paying the banks, there's actually other options, which I found out is even on the Canada website as well. Talks about self-directed RRSP and what is qualified investment for RRSPs. And one of the approved self-directed mortgages investment will be shown in this page here. Even gold and silver, coins, bullion, all these are proof. And if you can see here, it shows arm's length mortgages, non-arm's length mortgages, and mortgage-backed securities are all qualified investments. So, given the information I found, so I look around, there are a few banks that are actually doing it. I know CIBC recently added this feature, so mainly taking money out of your RRSP and liquidate it as cash. However, it's still in your RRSP. What happened is, instead of borrowing money from the bank, you borrowing money to yourself. using the RRSP funds available. And I found out some banks do it, but some banks doesn't. So you just have to ask around and ask an advisor what other options out there. So I know that self-directed mortgages, B2B bank, they do offer it, but I don't know too much about that. I know for the fact that that's another lender, Canadian Western Trust. There's more information here describing what this is. So welcome to call them up and ask about it if you're interested in it. So this is the 1-800 number. And also I know the Manulife Bank, they have this product called Manulife One. I'm not sure whether you heard of it before. So what it is everything in one account, your mortgages, your line of credits, everything. So if let's say you have a positive balance in your account, let's say 5,000, and usually you let it sit in your bank account without doing anything. But right now, if let's say you have it with Manulife Bank, that 5,000 is actually paying towards the principal for your mortgages. Hence, your mortgage will be paid down much faster. So this is one of the method. The other thing I saw that day was Freedom Mobile. This is one of the cell phone company. They have a prepaid plan. And for some people, if they're looking for like connectivity locally, calling, texting, all free, but without the data plan. So this is pretty good price. It's only $99 per year. Yep, so you save quite a bit. So before renewing your contracts, it's a good idea to check all your mobile companies. And I also recently found out Shaw, if you have the internet, they do have a promotion. And that promotion is, it says here, you get $0 per month, so you pay nothing for using unlimited Canada and white calling and global texting without the data, of course. But if you have like a Shaw internet, then it would be a bonus. So if you want more data, you possibly have to look at other plans, like, you know, adding more money to get more. So this is what I know so far. This is part one of the video. If you like what you see, please let me know and I will share more on the next video. Thanks for watching. Thank you for your support and I wish you a wonderful evening.